College had many proud traditions, but poor sportsmanship is not one of them. The student-athletes' involvement in intercollegiate activities contributes to the development of their core values of fairness, integrity, honesty, and respect. These values are an integral part of a competitive yet positive game environment. Hope College, St. Mary's, the MIAA, and the NCAA promote good sportsmanship by its student-athletes, coaches, and spectators. Profanity, racist, or sexist comments or other intimidating actions directed at student-athletes, coaches, officials, or other fans is not permitted and will not be tolerated during today's game. As always, we remind you to be loud, be proud, and be positive.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Matt Wehner alongside Paul Willard with this edition of Hope College Women's Basketball. We're live from DeVos Fieldhouse. Got an exciting one. Opportunity for the Hope College women's team coming off of a tough loss to Albion last week. They're looking for that redemption, looking to take this opportunity to really get back on track as a 14-2 team, one of the top teams in the country, looking to find that opportunity so they can move into conference play. Once again, hoping to gain that MIAA title. Paul, yeah. We're excited here tonight. What are
I'm excited. Well, it's the first of two games tonight. There's a men's game to follow tonight. I won't, unfortunately, be on that call, but our good friend Jordan George, I believe, is coming in for that one.
And I'll be here to do color for that, for the men's game as well. So, yeah, we got a doubleheader here. You're going to want to see both of them. We've got a good matchup here with St. Mary's.
And I think, too, the Hope women are, like you mentioned, they're looking to rebound from a very, very tough loss at Albion against a very good Albion team, really trying to get back in the ranks of the MIAA standings here and really just kind of step into trying to vie for first or second place here. Hopefully, Trine and Albion will falter a little bit down the stretch.
Yeah, definitely, and I think Hope will want to take that opportunity. Calvin will be out for blood after that 62-56 win earlier in the season. Calvin will be out for blood for them. But, hey, we're going to be back. I had an opportunity to talk to Coach Morehouse. We'll be back to talk more about that. But right now, let's go to starting lineups.
Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America with the singing of our national anthem, please welcome Hope College freshman, Miss Mary Krause.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Mary Krause. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the DeVos Fieldhouse here on the campus of Hope College for today's MIAA contest between the Bells of St. Mary's and your Hope College Flying Dutch. Here are tonight's starting lineups. First for St. Mary's at 1-4, a 5-9 senior from Walled Lake. Number 2, Maddie Rezepka. And at 1-4 for the Flying Dutch, a 5-11 senior from Ada. Number 4, Claire Bagley. Starting at 1-4 for St. Mary's, a 6-1 sophomore from Dyer, Indiana. Number 34, Julia Schutz. And at 1-4 for the Flying Dutch, a 6-foot senior from Sycamore, Illinois. Number 14, Kate Majerus. At center for St. Mary's, a 6-2 junior from Troy. Number 42, Athena Sampson. And at center for the Flying Dutch, a 6-1 senior from Osceola, Indiana. Number 21, Savannah Feenstra. At one guard for St. Mary's, a 5-5 junior from Logansport, Indiana. Number 4, Ellie Deerdorf. And at one guard for the Flying Dutch, a 5-8 senior from Zeeland. Number 2, Meg Morehouse. And at the final guard spot for St. Mary's, a 5-5 senior from Chicago, Illinois. Number 25, Nikki Murphy. And at the final guard spot for the Flying Dutch, a 5-9 senior from Hazlitt, number 15, Ella McKinney. St. Mary's is coached by Melissa Mikelski. Hope College is coached by Brian Morehouse. Your officials this evening, Rob Stanaway, Tim Feckety, and Don Slater.
We're back live here from DeVos Fieldhouse. Matt Wehner alongside Paul Willard. We've got an exciting one here. As you see the starting lineup, senior-led roster, of course, from Coach Morehouse's group. Feenstra, McKinney, Bagley, Majerus, and Morehouse. And this is a team that, I mean, they've had so much experience, as we've talked about a lot, senior-led, yep. And they have a big mission getting back to that national title.
They sure do.
The opportunity to talk to Coach Morehouse yesterday. The main thing he said is, I asked him, you know, you're having four freshmen play 10-plus minutes, and he said, you know, they're learning. It takes a lot of grit, a lot of time to learn our defense. Some days are spectacular. Some days they're learning a lot from not being successful. So we got tip-off here, and we'll see if we get some of that later on. It's going to be an early foul.
A quick foul on Savannah Feenstra, it looked like, right? Did they call a foul on her for that? Or maybe she traveled?
I think they just called like a turnover.
That was
because of the weird way that the ball came down. So yeah. It will be St. Mary's basketball. You're there for the Bells. Bring it at the top of the key here. It's Murphy. Good push away there. Ooh. By Morehouse as they're fighting for the basketball.
Yep. Nice hustle by Morehouse. Of course, Morehouse known for her stalwart defense, her absolutely pestering the offensive players of whatever team they're up against. But Meg Morehouse is a scorer, too. You know, she, I heard from one of my colleagues that Meg Morehouse was a prolific scoring machine when she was in high school.
Yeah, at Zeeland High School, the graduate. And here's McKinney in transition out to Feenstra for three. She's got it.
Yeah.
Nothing but nylon. You know, that would be Majerus for
Majerus.
Three. Getting it off the top. And here's Bell's
if Kate's stroking it that early and then she is hitting those from three, that's a good sign for the Hope Flying Dutch tonight.
Early 3-0 lead, and they're going to get a foul on Morehouse. Touch foul there on the hands. We'll have the Bells with the ball out of bounds. Bells' opportunity really is going to be if they can get back in transition, try and take away that low post game from Hope. That's a nice three there. That's Ellie Deerdorf. Quickly in transition is Bagley. Rebound brought down by the Bells. Here come the Bells pushing across the timeline now.
Yeah, I like to see the Bells taking a three right away on their second possession here. You know, really trying to make their presence known on this court here. You know, St. Mary's not coming in with the greatest record. Hope sitting at 14-2 right now. So St. Mary's coming in with a lot to prove.
When you're a team like the Bells, 6-10 coming on the road, you have to establish early and often defensively that they're going to be able to make stops and stay in this ball game. That's a good up and under there. That's Rzepka, their leading scorer. She's 13 a game for the Bells. It's 5-3 is the Bells' lead. The other side of the court, they're going to get a travel by McKinney just on that jump stop. She was trying to get her feet going on the pivot. It will be another Hope College turnover.
Yeah, that happens a lot. The refs are really keying in on that. I noticed that a lot this season. Hope's been called a lot for the little one-and-a-half step before the dribble type of move. And it seems like the refs are trying to clamp down on Hope's ability to do that this season, because there's been a lot of traveling calls against the Flying Dutch this year so far.
Deerdorf trying to get that ball down to Sampson. They're five. We're going to see if they can get some more low post work. And here's on the drive is Schutz. Schutz is out to Gumma. Gumma pestered there by Bagley. They're going to get Bagley
nice
on
defense
a foul.
By Claire, though. Really, really good job to hang in there and really not allow any space. But unfortunately, she a little bit too much contact, maybe, Matt, I'm thinking.
Yeah, it looks like just a little bit too much hands in the face is what mm-hmm. they saw. Very minimal contact, and that's two quick fouls on Hope, one on Morehouse, one on Bagley. It's almost stolen there by Majerus. Shot taken up by Schutz is off the mark. Rebound brought down by Bagley. Here's Morehouse in transition. She gets it out. Kick out to Majerus. Nice pass to McKinney. McKinney, can she get the one she wants? She does.
Yeah.
And it goes. Here come the Bells. It's like you said, Paul, I mean, their opportunity is really going to be trying to get it out in transition, but there's the steal by McKinney. McKinney to Majerus. Majerus up in the middle. Easy
nice
two for Feenstra.
Great vision by Majerus to see Feenstra streaking down the middle of the court there.
It's like they've done this a time or two.
That's right, absolutely, yeah. It's kind of like they drew it up that way.
Right. Here's Murphy. Murphy, you know, trying to drive, get it down to the post. She kicks out, and that's out to Deerdorf.
Nice pass steal.
Stolen by Feenstra. Feenstra out in transition, gets to McKinney for the easy two, and she is blocked on her way
wow.
out. Beautiful block there by Murphy.
Nice defensive hustle back there for Murphy to get back for the Bells and really disrupt McKinney's shot. I think Ella thought that she had kind of a free play right there.
Right.
And was all alone under the basket until she wasn't.
She saw the easy two, and like I was saying, that's one of those things I was talking to Coach Morehouse about. Their opportunity to stay in this game is going to be getting out in transition, not giving up those easy buckets. Majerus is hot early. Another three.
From almost the exact same spot that she hit that first one. Like I said, if Kate's hitting those threes, this is going to be a long night for the Bells with Kate out on that wing hitting those three-pointers.
The Bells trying to get their offense going. So much on-ball pressure, not allowing that opportunity to get it down to the low post. Here's Deerdorf. Sets up for three, and she gets it to
go. The bank is open.
Beautiful shot by Deerdorf. Here's Morehouse.
You know, that's one of those shots that you take from far out, and then when it goes in off the bank, you say, I totally meant to do that.
Hope going around the cylinder here, see if they can get an easy look. McKinney, she's stolen there.
Good hands by number two.
Transition. Ball's going to be off of Rzepka.
Yep.
We're going to get some quick subs in here. Let's see who we got for the Dutchman. It's going to be the freshman Carl Bloom and Sitsma, and then the sophomore Garner coming in.
Yeah. Jada Garner coming in, averaging quite a few minutes per game and really increasing her minutes per game from last season and her point total. One of the remarkable things that I had heard early on in the season was that Jada Garner has really stepped up her game to be in the second wave of starters.
Speaking of which, she just misses the reverse layup. Beautiful look there by Garner. The Bells quickly, once again, across the timeline. That's their play. Nice crossover move by Rzepka. Can she get it to go?
And a travel.
She gets called for the travel. Yep. Another turnover by the Bells.
Just a few too many steps as she was falling to the ground. Really didn't maintain her dribble. And that's the right call there by the refs, unfortunately. I think some of the Bells maybe wanted a foul there, but that was definitely the right call.
So Bell set up, still with a man-to-man. They're trying to stick with that on-ball pressure. Hope going to see if they can get it down to the low post. McKinney wants opportunity to move, and she's going to get called for 3 seconds. She thought that she got her left foot outside the circle. Apparently did not. So another Hope College turnover.
You know, those three-second calls and those five-second out-of-bounds timers tend to go way faster than you think, right?
That's that turnover there by Deardorff, but it is picked up back by the Bells. That's a nice take by Schutz. She can't get it to go.
Nice board by Sietzma there to get that ball.
Let's see what Garner wants to set up here. Morehouse wants tempo as he's calling to his guard. Garner up and under. That's an easy two. She gets it to go.
Great slice move there by Garner. And no help on the backside for the Bells, unfortunately. She was able to get to the basket with ease, really.
And, Paul, you can feel the pace already. I don't know if it's St. Mary's or it's Hope, but both teams love this pace.
Yeah. Yeah, there is not a wasted moment in this game thus far. A lot of pushing the pace. Not very many stoppages thus far, except for a few fouls here and there. A few traveling calls that we've had, but you know, like we said, not very many stoppages just yet. So Hope looking to push the pace, really looking to come out and assert their dominance, especially after that loss to Albion.
McKinney gets called for the foul. So it will be.
That's
Bell's
two on McKinney, yeah?
Outside, trying to get the ball in. Two on McKinney. And good rebound there by Carl Bloom. Out in transition now is Garner. Let's see where Garner wants to do with it. She's trying to drive and kick. Good look to Sitzma. Sitzma, can it be strong?
Nice.
It was strong enough. Good two there. Hope College with the lead, 14-8. Nice steal by Carl Bloom. Out in transition, here's Bagley. Good pump fake. And Hope demanding to be known early and often against this Bells team, making their identity known.
Doubling up on the Bells now, 16-8 in favor of the Dutch. That's going to be a foul on Sietzma.
I'll tell you what I am happy about. I mean, Hope getting called for a lot of fouls, but the reffing is very consistent. So it gives an opportunity in these last three quarters for you to figure out, okay, I'm not going to be able to get away with that hands call. The call that I'm going to get other games, they're not having it.
Yeah.
A couple more freshmen in the ballgame. That's Sydney Weiss, and then that's
Keegan Kaiser
in there for the Dutch. Defense going to be off of Deardorff, so that will be Hope College basketball. Great steal there.
Yeah.
16-8, Hope College lead. A lot of pace, as we've talked about. Many transition buckets so far. It's a Dutch team that's very comfortable in transition, like we've talked about, very experienced. Here's Morehouse back in to lead the offense. Garner's going to take a seat on the bench. Kaiser trying to get down to the low post. There's Feenstra. But under nice driving kick. Majerus for three. Yep,
there
why
it
not?
Is.
That's my third, and I can do it again.
Yeah, have yourself 9 points tonight, Kate Majerus. There you go. All triple tries and a travel on number 23 for the Bells. That's Jasmine Townsend. Lots of travels tonight here, Matt. Like, that's think about the fourth one called thus far, right?
I think when you have all those opportunities in transition, it just opens up both teams to be a little bit more careless with the basketball, as you've seen a lot more turnovers than we're used to. Feenstra so strong.
Oh,
anytime
and one.
She wants to.
And one, Savannah.
Anytime she wants to. If that low post is open,
that's
she
right.
has too much positioning back to the basket, and that's a main reason why Hope can be so dominant. The way they're able to get that positioning low post between both McKinney and Feenstra, that's their favorite move. She gets it to go. 22-8. Hope College demanding that the Bells know that they can score anytime they want to. Let's see if Deardorff can get something going. Sorry, that's Murphy, the guard.
And I think we're approaching about 3 or 4 minutes here for the Bells without a bucket yet. So Hope really starting to come out and play tough and really make their transitions as fruitful as possible, you know, when they get down to the when they get down to their end and score.
The air ball there on the three-point attempt by the Bells, rebound brought down by Morehouse. Let's see if Kaiser's gonna bring it up the timeline. She's moving with pace. Drives, dishes, Morehouse for three. Off the front.
And the rebound brought down by Weiss. Nice chase down by Sydney, yeah. That's what you like. That's really good hustle by Sydney Weiss there.
That's what she does well. She's a freshman that plays 9.5 minutes a game. She's also in double digits in scoring per game. She will shoot the three as well.
Oh, unfortunate there.
Ball is out and around as Townsend gets the ball on the ground. She's able to get the two. 26-10 is the Hope College lead. We've got Kaiser down to Feenstra. Feenstra up and under, too strong.
Yeah, that's too easy for Savannah when she gets that down in that low post and can dribble and make it, you know, make one step around the defender and put it up and in. That's kind of her favorite move, I think, right?
She loves that. Once she gets that kind of depth down there, Savannah does such a good job with positioning. That's a nice two look by Schutz. The rebound by Feenstra, and it looks like they're going to get Murphy on the foul.
Yeah, nice board by Savannah there, and really nice play to draw the foul from the Bells there. Again, that toughness that you want to see from the Flying Dutch, coming out here with that toughness, bringing the pace, pushing the pace, and getting down and scoring, and actually, you know, playing lockdown defense like they are. Bells still sitting at 10 points here.
Hope, a team that they can do so many things offensively very well. They're so hard to prepare for. They average 87 points
a
game.
Oh, nice pass.
Feenstra just off the back. She can't get the two to go.
That was a great, great pass by Keegan Kaiser to thread that needle through there.
That's a nice pass on the other end by Murphy, but it's going to be a turnover. Now looks like it's off the hands of Nicole Connolly. So here's Hope College basketball. We got 1:10 to play here in the first period. Here comes Garner, top of the key, driving dish. Feenstra, she had an open look. They want to get it down to the low post. Too much room for Majerus. Weiss picks up the three.
Oh, nice shot. Local product Sydney Weiss from Byron Center, Michigan, hitting the three. Really hitting the three balls tonight, too. Kate Majerus with 9 all three-pointers. Sydney Weiss with the three-pointer now.
And, Paul, when you're coming off a game against Albion, they shot 6 of 30 three-point range, only shooting 20%, a team that's typically 33-35% from three.
Yep.
Hope College, they're going to have to be a team that's 35-40%.
That's right.
They want to have those same expectations that they had, and something Coach Morehouse had talked about.
Yeah, and even in the Albion game, they only shot about 23% from the field. And, definitely looking to increase that tonight as well. As the foul shot goes in there for number 23, Jasmine Townsend for the Bells.
Townsend's got 3. She gets another bucket to go. We got 42 seconds to play. Hope College with a 19-point lead. Here's Garner across the timeline. Garner in charge, out to Weiss. Weiss, that low post. So many options, but she
gets nice steal.
Stolen by Murphy in transition. Here's Rzebka.
Can't in get and it out.
Rebound brought down by Feenster. Here's Kaiser with pace. Ooh, nice pass over to Weiss. We'll be saying those two names for the next 4 years.
Yeah, that's right.
Weiss and Kaiser, the freshmen.
Played
minutes apiece.
We talk about Hope being a senior-laden team as they were last year, but there are quite a few dynamic first-year players and second-year players on this squad who can really do everything.
When you have Weiss and Carl Blum and Kaiser, as well as Sitzma playing so many minutes, a huge recipe for success with the easy two there by Majerus. And here on the defensive end, looks like Murphy trying to get that up with the right. That'll be it for the first quarter. We got 33-12. It's the Hope College lead. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back here from DeVos Fieldhouse. Just a few. Yeah. Back live to Boss Fieldhouse. Matt Wainer alongside Paul Willard. Early Hope College lead, 33-12. What have you seen so far that's been good for the Dutch?
Yeah.
You know, this is a team for Hope College that, as they prepare here with 10 minutes to play, we're going to start here with Morehouse. The basketball, she's at the top of the key. There's Feenstra. Feenstra down, easy move there to Morehouse. Morehouse gets it up and under. And there's a rebound brought down by Majerus. Here's Feenstra out to Morehouse for three. Can't get it to go. On to Feenstra. Back two offensive boards in a row there for Hope. Here's Bagley out to McKinney. On the drive is Majerus, and Majerus going to get called for that travel.
So you asked me what I saw in that first quarter there. Well, we just kind of saw it right here with Kate Majerus and that travel. Lots of travel calls. I think that's about the sixth or seventh one tonight thus far. But in all seriousness, I think we saw the Dutch really kind of push the pace, really clamping down defensively. You know, St. Mary's went about 4.5 minutes without a bucket. And of course, you know, shooting a lot better for the Flying Dutch tonight, too. Kate Majerus with 9 points, all three-pointers. Sydney Weiss with the three. And Savannah Feenstra just letting her will be known down in the paint tonight, too.
First quarter, Hope shot the ball 47% from the field. That's a recipe for success coming off a game where they were shooting only 25% from the field. Gets Albion. Here's Morehouse on the drive. She's out to McKinney for three. That's the one she likes.
Yep.
Can't get it to go. Great rebound by Majerus. Hope killing the Bells on the offensive boards. Down to Feenstra in that low post. Can she do what she wants? She gets fouled on the way up by Schutz.
Yeah, nice move by Savannah down there, though, again. Again, like I mentioned, you know, Savannah really, when she's in the paint, she's going to let her will be known, and she's going to step through and make as many moves as she can to try to put it up and in.
And you wonder, too, Paul, I mean, if the Bells want to consider doing some sort of front, they could do a double on Feenstra to take away that low post. It's the only problem there is when Hope's shooting above 30% from three, they're going to give up a lot on the outside.
That's right.
You got to pick your battle here.
Yeah, you wonder if, you know, here, you know, maybe a timeout here or, you know, at the half, if the Bells are going to make any sort of adjustment to kind of double up Feenstra, just because that post play right now for Hope has just been so dominant. And every trip down the court that Savannah's in the post, they're walking away with 2 points. So
it looks like from what the Bells must have talked about at the quarter, they're trying to slow this game down because they want to stay in it. Down 22 points. The look is up there by Schutz, but the rebound is brought down by Majerus. Here's McKinney. Hope continuing to push that wicked pace. And there's Sitzma at the top of the key. Sitzma to Bagley. Little screen and roll. Can they get it to go? Bagley out to Majerus. She thought about it, but she drives. Majerus off the block. Oh. And it's stolen by Schutz. Schutz in transition. Setting up Dierdorf. Dierdorf trying to get the offense here. And she fires a three off the back iron. Rebound brought down by Morehouse. Morehouse, beautiful pass in transition to Majerus. To Bagley for three. Air ball.
Yep. Yeah, from our vantage point here too, as soon as Claire let that go, I could tell that it didn't really have a hope and a prayer to make it to the basket. But that's okay though, you know, because like you were talking about, Hope is really pushing the pace and they're getting out in transition. They're putting shots up, which of course, you know, if they don't go in, doesn't help their percentage. But you know, at least maybe they're going to wear out the Bells in that way by pushing the pace here.
You know, if they're a team, if they can be on pace for 50 at half and get to 100 in the game, it's going to be really difficult for any team to stay within that.
Absolutely.
Scrum on the ground and a tie up
here. Jump ball. Arrow favors the St. Mary's Bells here. So the ball will stay down at this end. Inbounds play now for number 44. For the Bells.
It's Christina Shadid, the inbound passer. She's trying to get it in. One-handed catch made by Rzepka. Rzepka, leading scorer for the season.
Tough in the paint there for Rzepka. Really nice movement to get around Bagley on that play, though.
Just Bagley with the driving kick. McKinney, the shot she likes.
Yeah.
And that's a swish.
Ella's not going to miss those shots, especially when she's left uncontested wide open.
A senior that's shot many in her career. She's comfortable from that position. You cannot leave her that open. 25 is the Hope College lead. Almost stolen there. Is it Sampson trying to get her positioning? They get it out. The three by Shadid. Rebound by Sampson. Sampson fighting for it. It's in the hands of Shadid. Here at the top of key is Deerdorf down in the low post to Sampson. Yep, that's a good look.
Yeah, nice little scoop there by Sampson to get around Sietsma. You know, Hope again. Oh, unfortunate there. Oh, wow, great defense by Hope there. Really, had Jada touched that ball, it would have been a backcourt violation. So actually worked out in Hope's favor that the Bells got to it first. And then Hope played some solid defense to disrupt that shot.
Just Hope setting up the offense. Garner trying to move around that screen. She gets the kick. Carl Bloom for three. Yep.
Yeah.
And she does. So they did what they said they wanted to do. They
That's
wanted
right.
to shoot it a little bit better from three, and they are tonight.
Yeah, and you know in practices this week, Mo and his team of coaches were really trying to clamp down on shot selection, taking high percentage shots, and making sure that they were really doing everything they could to get the most out of their trips down the floor.
Great drive by Bagley.
And one for Bagley.
Gets the and one. Wonderful drive. She just had a step there on Rzepka. You hate to be in that position when you're a defender and you can't stay and force the offensive player to at least make one move. You're going to get caught behind. Bagley just too quick. Too good at the bucket. Let's see if she can get one to go. And Paul with 42-14. I mean, what do you think that at halftime the Bells need to do to get in position to once again get back in this ball game, because it's slowly becoming a game that is getting out of reach?
Yeah, you know, I think defensively for the Bells, you know, what they're probably going to do is make some halftime adjustments and try to double up and then be as fast as they can to disrupt some of those shots that are certainly going to come out on the wing as they try to double up in the post, like we were talking about earlier. Another travel call tonight. I haven't been keeping a tally, but that feels like it's 9.
Yeah, Townsend's.
That's a lot. That's a lot of travel calls on the evening tonight.
Townsend's had a few. And in for the Hope College Dutch, we got Bellows, as well as the freshman Keegan Kaiser. So we've got Kaiser, Bellows, Weiss in there, the underclassman. Weiss just a little too strong with the left. It's in the hands of Murphy. Murphy bringing up the timeline. See, and she dishes, tried to get the kick out. They're moving around. Townsend thought about it. She wants the isolation. She, ooh, a beautiful pass. I love that look.
Yeah, really nice look there for the Bells.
That's off the glass by Giroux. This is going to be Hope College basketball.
Hey, we're seeing Olivia Bellows for the first time tonight, the product, sophomore product out of Lake City, Michigan. Olivia Bellows in the first game of the season, I believe, with quite the offensive explosion. I think she scored 19 or 20 points. Nice take by Kaiser there. Hope I feel like she just took two steps and made it to the basket. I don't know how, because she's not a very tall player.
She's watching enough Luka Doncic.
She does
a good job with the Euro step there.
Yeah.
And Hope College demanding everything that they need right now with the 31-point lead. Rebound brought down by Majerus. Here's Majerus out to Kaiser. Hope showing no signs of wanting to slow down, expecting that they're trying to get to a little higher number. Great look by Bellows on the fake to Weiss.
Yeah.
She gets it to go. That's just way too many points coming in the paint for Hope.
It's nice really look off there on the fake pass to Sydney Weiss by Bellows, too. Nice interception.
Pass stolen away, and that's by Weiss. Weiss in transition. She looks, dish. Kaiser thinks about it, and yes for three.
Oh.
Can't get it to go. Rebound brought down by Sampson.
I thought that was going to bounce right in the net after it hit the back iron there for a second. Nice steal by Kaiser here. Looking to push it. See if she can get down. And draws the foul as she goes up.
foul is on Townsend. You can see Kaiser free throw line now for two.
Great play by Kaiser to read that, though, and intercept that pass. Two subs now in the game for Hope. Sophomores Raven Jemison, the 6'3 product out of East Kentwood, and Hannah Kearns. My bad. I think I said that Raven was a sophomore. She's a junior. Correction on that. My bad.
Kaiser misses the front end of the first. Hope College, the 33-point lead. Misses the second two. Rebound is brought down by Goralchik. Here's Murphy. Murphy quickly across the timeline. On-ball pressures by Bellows, not allowing that.
Ooh.
She wasn't allowing that.
Yeah, Raven getting hit with the reach in there as she was trying to knock that ball away.
It may have been a gift. I thought Bellows had a little bit with the hands on Murphy earlier, so may have been a little bit of a makeup. Let's see who comes in here now for Hope College. It's going to be the sophomore Courtney Lee from Fishers, Indiana.
And Lena Ray, I believe, number 24.
She's got a young lineup in there. Bellows, Ray, Jemison, Lee, and Kearns.
Oh, a good look there. Nice rebound by Courtney Lee.
Here's Lay. Ray playing some of her first minutes here tonight. And there's Jemison as she gets it batted away there. It's going to be off of her foot, so it will be ball headed towards the Bells.
Yeah, Hope really kind of spreading the wealth around tonight, you know, with their bench and getting some, you know, important minutes for the non-starters down, you know, for the season and trying to get them in the game. And nice take there. You know, it's always important to get the new players some in-game experience. You know, of course, in practices, all of these players play a huge role.
And like you say, I think that's a big part.
Oh, nice.
The type of culture and the type of team that Coach Morehouse wants to build is a team that has freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors contributing. As you can see, none of the starters playing more than 22 minutes a game. McKinney leading all minutes totals with 22 a game. And this is a team that, when you can play 10 deep with 10-plus minutes a game, huge recipe for success for years to come, too. Dutchman all around the horn. Giving it up, and here's Bellows on the left side. Fake, good penetration there. Rebound comes back into the hands of Bellows. Bellows out the top of the key, and there's down to Kearns, gets it down. Jemison up and under.
And one.
Gets the and one.
Yeah. I was a little nervous that Jemison was almost too close to the basket there. I didn't think she was going to be able to get that one up and in. But a nice move there by Jemison. A really good job of Hope working the ball around. You know, really playing.
And as we look at the replay there, you can see Jemison, as she's hearing from her. From the Hope College bench telling her 3-2-1, like, you only got a couple seconds left, we got to get this ball up.
That's right.
Jemison at the free throw line cannot get the and one to go. Rebound brought down by Goralchik. Quickly across the timeline, and quickly a turnover for the Bells.
Yeah, just before about a minute 25 left in this game here, Hope hitting the 51-point mark. Always a good sign for the Dutch to hit the century mark for the game when they score 50 and a half. We'll see if that's the case tonight, as it has been the case on a few occasions this season and last season as well. Yep, Raven gets the foul, draws the foul there in the paint. You know, Raven, a 6'3 player in the paint, right? I mean, nothing you can do except foul her when she's down in there.
And it's a good luxury to have for your Coach Morehouse.
Absolutely.
A player that can come off the bench. She's not playing massive amount of minutes this year, but really somebody that, when you have those opportunities, she comes in defensively and she does such a good job. So when you have that amount of talented players, you don't have to ask too much of your starters.
That's
because
right.
You have opportunities to bring in 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 players to come into the ball game. Jemison gets a second to go. We got a minute 13 left in half. Let's see what Townsend wants to do. That's up by Guma. Guma can't get it go. It's blocked, and here's in transition. There's Kearns. Kearns down to Jemison. Jemison out to Bellows. Bellows sets up with a fake on the dribble. It's off her leg. It's going to be Bell's basketball now.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. It looked like Bellows was going to drive baseline and maybe kick it out or take it herself, and then just the unfortunate thing of bouncing it right off of her shin.
There's Goralchik. She gets
nice
swatted
block.
Away by Townsend.
Yeah, Bellows going to draw the foul as they were getting out in transition. So looks like Bellows is going to the line now to shoot. Is it one and one or two?
Looks like they're in the bonus. Looks like there are going to be two shots here for Bellows. Foul line, 42 seconds to play in the half.
Nice.
It's the first to go. Hope College getting back to their ways, just the way that they wanted this one to go.
Yeah.
It looks like they're going to head into half with a 38-point lead. College doing everything that they need to do. So much to be happy about if you're a Hope College fan early now. Because let's see what the Bells want to do here. They might get one more possession. Two if they're lucky. They're out. Townsend thinks about it. She puts the ball on the ground. That's a nice look.
Nice shot.
Nice look as she rattles it home. Here's Ray bringing it up. Last possession here for the Dutchman for halftime. See what Ray wants to do here. A lot of spread out there. Can't get it down to Jemison. They think about it. Yep, and they do, and she's doubled, but it's too
nice.
Easy.
Yep.
It's just too easy of a bucket for her.
That's right. Dutch with 56 now going into half. Shot up. And no good for the Bells. Yeah, what a great half of basketball if you're a Hope Flying Dutch fan. A lot to be thankful for with how the Dutch are playing. St. Mary's really just getting stifled on the offensive end by Hope's defense. And Hope really getting out in transition tonight and pushing the pace, which I think is, bothering the Bells a little bit here.
56-18 is the Hope College lead. We'll take a break. We'll be back here about 15 minutes to overcome that first half and then a look ahead as to what we're going to see here in the second half. Matt Wainer alongside Paul Willard. We'll be right back.
Moment in American history. There's some big questions on the table, such as how do we indeed become a land of opportunity for all rather than a land of privilege for a few? And the answer to that question is being decided, not just in the political arena and not just through cultural conversations. The answer to that question is being decided, perhaps most importantly of all, through the admissions and financial aid processes on college campuses across the country. Because higher education has the potential to indeed make us a land of opportunity for all. Higher education can be the great equalizer. We spend a lot of time talking about income inequality, but at the end of the day, income is the outcome. What we ought to be talking about is education inequality. higher education can be the great equalizer. Research shows this. There's an economist at Harvard named Raj Chetty, and his research shows that a student who comes from a low-income background and a student who comes from a high-income background, if they attend the same college or university, they have nearly identical opportunities for success after they graduate. But the problem, of course, is that those students don't attend the same colleges and universities. And another economist, Carolyn Hoxby at Stanford, shows that one of the main reasons that students who would be eligible to attend great universities and often would be eligible for financial aid, one of the main reasons they don't attend is the price, the sticker price. The sticker price scares people off. And what we're seeing now, because there's new data out, new data shows that many high schoolers are eliminating colleges from consideration because of the price, because of the posted price. In fact, data out this year shows that 73% of high schoolers eliminated college from consideration because of the posted price. And that number, 73%, is up from 68% last year and up from 56% 2 years ago. Access to higher education is a problem. But what we see at Hope College is that there's another problem, which is access to a life of impact after students graduate. Because the students who do find their way into higher education oftentimes, too oftentimes, are burdened by debt. And that debt skews the kind of things that students are doing after they graduate. Too often students, because they have so much debt, are chasing income rather than pursuing a life of impact. And they're chasing income because they have to pay off their debt. Hope Forward is a vision that we have at Hope College that will eliminate these problems of access. Hope Forward gives all students at Hope College access to a great education that's fully funded up front. And then it gives them access to a life of impact after they graduate because they're not burdened by debt. It asks students to pay for their education through gifts after they graduate rather than a large tuition bill up front. And for us at Hope College, this will move the mission of Hope forward to new heights. But we also think this might be a new national model for higher education. We think this vision might be a model that could work at other places to help indeed make this country a land of opportunity for all.
We know. It wasn't what you expected. An entire year filled with uncertainty, confusion, doubt, and tension. There was loss. There was pain. We all felt the fear and the grief. An entire year wondering, is this the new normal? Will everything be all right? Yet, it was also a year filled with determination, community, innovation, and resilience. When it seemed like all was lost, we found ourselves gaining new gifts, perspectives, and purpose. We found a new appreciation for a stranger's smile, stayed connected even from afar. We had time to learn something new or revisit an old love. This year reminded us to cherish our unity, our identity, rooted in Christ as we welcome an undefined future together. And so, we return. Return to pushing the limits of human knowledge, pushing ourselves to unknown potential, to shared passions, pursuing wisdom, and passing on traditions. We're returning to wonder, to worship, to a world where hope has a new meaning. And though it was never really gone, hope is back. And hope changes everything.
Thank you. And what we're imagining now, as we look out to the future, is not just a tweak to the old system. We're imagining an entirely new system. In a Hope Forward model, every student who comes through the doors of Hope College would have their tuition 100% covered.
Trigvi Johnson, and I serve as the Dean of the Chapel at Hope College. I'd like to thank you for your continued relationship with Hope. Thank you for being our people. People are what make this campus special, a people rooted in our shared faith in Jesus Christ. And in that spirit, I'd like to personally invite you to come join us for chapel every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10:30 a.m. Come and join the next generation of Hope College students as we sing the old songs of the faith and some new ones. Come and enter in and experience the energy and vitality of what it is to be a Christian here at Hope College, as God shapes us to be a people of hope now and for future generations.
Every day, the people of Hope College are
leading,
discovering,
believing,
dreaming,
pursuing,
serving,
innovating,
exploring,
creating,
collaborating,
questioning,
curing.
We are finding new ways to do old things.
We are challenging the status quo
and building a legacy.
We are pursuing truth.
We are solving tomorrow's problems today.
We are thinking globally.
We are faithfully hoping.
We are celebrating victories.
This day and every day,
we are strengthened by our faith,
bound by a shared commitment to building community,
and dedicated to providing our students with a world-class liberal arts education.
Faithful,
welcoming, transformational.
This is Hope College.
The River Place in downtown Holland redefines active senior living. A no-step floor plan is designed around your needs, so you can leave the worries of home ownership behind and enjoy a vibrant lifestyle right outside your door. Make the River Place your home. Visit resthaven.org/riverplace to reserve yours today.
Fieldhouse, Matt Wehner alongside Paul Willard, and it's been all Dutch early and often. 56-18 is the Hope College lead. Let's get a little update from some of the stats, Paul.
Yeah.
What do we have in that first half?
Well, I think we saw an early jump out for Kate Majerus, leading all scorers right now with 11, hitting 3 three-pointers right away. You know, and I think Hope really just pushing the pace there. We've got Deerdorf and Townsend tied right now for the lead for St. Mary's with 6 points apiece. And that's just not going to be enough to hang with this high-powered offense of the Dutch. You know, so hopefully, Matt, what do you think the Bells are going to do in the second half here to really kind of bring the intensity?
I would think that their best opportunity, I know it's going to be difficult to get back in this game, but I like if they tried to do a little double on the post or to front Hope's bigs.
Yep.
So if they have Beanstra on the block or McKinney, I would think that they would try and push her off the block to make her receive that ball outside of the block so that she had to work from a little bit more space. But you could even do a backside double and just always expect help side to come when they're trying to go up and under the basket. That's what I would try to do, and then just force Hope to shoot out of it. When you shoot that well in the first half from three, you can expect them to cool off a little bit. But I don't know. I mean, it's a 38-point game, and I think they're right to try and slow down the pace, but I think Hope is just going to try and rout them with a bunch of scoring here.
Yeah.
So here we are, second half action. Just getting started. Got Bagley out to the left there, Spienstra. Nice pass down to Bagley. And she gets the two to go. Too strong.
Nice work around there for, kind of that 1-2 pass between Bagley and Feenster there. Feenster with a nice find down to Bagley.
She just works off the slip of that screen. Good hands there by McKinney. It's off hers. Back in the hands of the Bells. So to Murphy. Murphy, Deerdorf wants a three. She can't get it to go. She had a couple in the first half. She'll need to get going if they want to score here in the second.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, you kind of wonder, too, if you mentioned the Bells' defensive pressure here. You're really kind of wondering if the Bells are going to start to put some more pressure up top here because that's where Hope really kind of makes their bread and butter. They have it out up top, and they work the ball around and see what they can find for passes.
Majerus for three, can't get it to go.
The first three-pointer that Majerus has missed tonight, actually, so.
That's right, so it's a rebound is brought down by the Bells, and here they are in their front court. Here's Murphy trying to get up, get it a little bit of room, see if she can get around the basket, get one she likes. Deerdorf will chuck, no problem, but it's off the mark. Rebound brought down by Morehouse. Morehouse here with vision, out to Bagley. Bagley, easy room to drive anytime.
Oh, nice.
Anytime I want to.
That curl on the ball for Bagley as she was going up and in there.
The senior can and the senior will.
That's right.
And there she goes. Morehouse, great on ball pressure, gets away with probably a foul there on the body. But we'll stay live.
Yeah.
And they're going to get it with the hands.
Get her,
too close to the body. Foul is on Morehouse.
You know, Meg, we talked about Meg Morehouse's defensive pressure and her, you know, in the high school was an offensive prolific scorer. But her hustle play on every single trip down the floor just is unmatched.
Say with all these seniors and with Morehouse especially, heart and soul, this Hope College team, the leadership and her relationship with head coach Brian Morehouse as her coach and her father. Where's Majerus thinks about it. Majerus drives. Can she kick? She gets the easy on the right side. That's Morehouse down to Feenster for the look. Feenster gets her own board.
And one. Too strong, Savannah Feenstra again. again, down in that low post, Savannah just imposing her will on the Bells tonight. And when Savannah's down in that post and she's making those moves and playing that strong, yeah, it's going to be a long night for the Bells, unfortunately. Old-fashioned three-point play there for Savannah now.
So she gets three on that bucket. And Savannah, like I said, I mean, if she's going to be that deep into the basket, it's really easy for her to get position. Rebound brought down by Feenstra. McKinney with pressure. She's got numbers. Ooh. It's just too much there. Yep. She can't get her feet down. That foul.
Julia Schutz.
It's going to be on Schutz. Schutz just trying to get her left foot down to see if she could get the charge call, but she doesn't. So foul on Schutz. Keeps the ball with the Dutch. McKinney to Bagley. Bagley setting up offense now. Morehouse looking at something off ball. There's McKinney, thinks about it. So much room for Morehouse, easy
yeah.
too.
Morehouse backing down in. You know, it's very rare that you see Meg Morehouse play down in the post, but anything's possible tonight with this Hope offense.
Kind of like sending a message. I mean, I'm a guard, but I can still get positioning down there. It's not a good sign if you're the Bells. There's a scrum on the ground.
Yeah.
See who they're going to get on the foul.
Nice work there by Majerus to draw that foul as she was hustling after that ball and just kind of got bumped from behind and kind of went down to one knee there as she was really trying to make some a play on the ball.
Foul on Schutz. There's Garner bringing the ball up. Garner across the timeline. It's out to the right hash, and there's out to Bagley. Bagley around the horn, down. Ill-advised entry pass by Sitzma, because it looked like...
It looked like it was about to be intercepted for sure, but you know, Ella McKinney with the nice physical play to step and come to that ball and then just kind of draw the foul against the Bells here.
So Sitzma, you can see, I mean, tell a little bit less of what Feenstra was doing. She was just too far off the block for that entry pass. The miss by McKinney and the rebound. Nice drive by Ella, too
yeah.
strong, up for two. McKinney's got seven now. Here's Townsend. She drives. She's got a lot of room to work with. Can't get the two to go. Rebound brought down by Carl Bloom. Carl Bloom with the handles out to Garner. Garner will initiate Hope College offense. McKinney, dribble drive. Lots of room
nice
to work.
Nice up and under.
Too strong. Rebound brought down by Carl Bloom out. And they'll set it back up. She thinks about it.
Nice shot there by Carl Bloom. Little 10-footer off of the wing here. Got her defender kind of up in the air with that head fake. And really nice backspin on that ball to really drop it right through the hoop, too.
There's Deerdorf off the glass. Rebound brought down. It's a scrum there brought down by Porter. So it's out to Townsend at the top of the key. Rzepka has been really quiet. She's their leading scorer.
Oh, Townsend. Nice little shooter's touch there.
Townsend gets it to go
yep.
off the glass. Here's Garner driving. In the corner, Bagley almost. Here's Sitzma with room.
Nice play by Sitzma down there.
It's a really quick burnt step by Kendall Sitzma, the freshman. Here's Deerdorf. 71-20 is the Hope College lead. And we're going to see if after these starters get a little bit of break, and we're going to see some new faces in here in a minute. Rebound brought down by Carl Bloom. Carl Bloom really does a good job. I mean, as a four, she dribbles it so well.
Yeah.
Which I'm very impressed by for a freshman. Her stature, be able to dribble,
nice
drive
take
well.
By Bagley.
That's just athletic.
Yeah.
That's extremely athletic by Bagley there. So much Hope College offense here. Coming up on scoring 20 just in this quarter, and we still have 4:50 to play in the third quarter. They get it down to the low post there. Sampson, that's
nice
a nice move.
Really nice move by Sampson there. Morehouse calling a timeout here, getting some of his starters some rest. Timeout Hope.
So it looks like a quick 30-second timeout. We're going to stay right here. It's just a substitution timeout
yep.
by Coach Morehouse. We're going to stay. We're about to get live ball. Not too often do you see at the college level Oh, he will take his 30. I'm sorry. So okay. Coach Morehouse is going to take his 30. We'll take a break here live from DeVos Fieldhouse.
It's no secret. The best way to learn about Hope College is to spend time on our campus. The Hope Admissions team invites you to a personalized visit experience you won't forget. Located in downtown Holland, Michigan, our historic campus is close to shopping and dining and just 10 minutes from Lake Michigan. We invite you to check out our campus tour options or sign up for an online tour with the Hope Admissions office. There's never been a better time to see Hope College. Visit us at hope.edu/admissions.
Back live from DeVos Fieldhouse, Matt Wehner alongside Paul Willard, 73-22 is the Hope College dominant lead by the Dutch. We'll see what Hope College is going to do here as they're going to get some subs here. It looks like right now it's the freshman Carlum, Kaiser, Sitzma, and Weiss in there, and then it's Garner, the lone sophomore, going to be in there as well. So here's Gardner across the timeline. She's out to Sitzma. Sitzma to Weiss, two open, and that's a swish. That is an easy shot by Sydney Weiss. Here's Townsend, dribble drive, dishes out. That's a
good look by Shadid.
Rebound brought down by Garner out in transition. Here's Carlblum, sets up. That's a nice look.
Shot.
Beautiful shot by Carlblum.
Yeah. You know, Hope's mid-range jumpers this year, I've noticed, have gotten a lot better. You know, those 10 to 12 footers, Ella McKinney taking a lot. Carlblum taking one just right there. She had one earlier on the other wing.
They're just very good shooters. Great job by Garner getting Weiss in transition. That's something Garner does so well. She's an extremely good distributor.
Yeah.
You can tell this Hope College offense can be in good hands when Meg Morehouse graduates.
Yeah, absolutely.
Try to get it down low post. That's a good look by Goralchik. But here in the hands of Carlblum. Carlblum drives up and under. And they're Townsend on the block.
Yep.
I thought her feet were set up. Referee saw something different.
Wondering if she may have been inside of the restricted area there for a second. Hard to know. Olivia Bellows checking into the game now for the Flying Dutch. Carlblum at the line shooting two.
It's Bellows and Jemison coming in the ballgames. See, here's Carlblum gets first to go.
Yeah. Now Hannah Kearns checking in for the Flying Dutch here. Looking again, you know, like they did in the first half, at the tail end of the first half, Hope getting all of their bench players in as much as they can, trying to get them some crucial minutes and some playing experience. But Hope's bench just so deep, unfortunately, for the Bells. Nice steal by Weiss.
These are a lot of good, valuable minutes for those underclassmen. Nice block there by Shadid. I love that, but Kearns get it.
Yeah.
Gets the board, and she gets the lefty to go.
Jemison with the nice assist there to see Kearns out right underneath the basket for that easy bucket there.
So here's Shadid. Shadid at the top of the key. Gets it out to Goralchik. And under there, back down to Goralchik. Oh, and she picks up her feet. Doesn't get the travel call. And there's Jemison with the board. Out to Kearns. Kearns now to Kaiser to set up the offense. Kaiser out in her own. There's Bice on the right wing. Down to Jemison with some moves. Yep, she has
it. Nice step through by Raven there.
She has the moves.
Yep. A couple head fakes here and there. A nice little step through and up and in for Raven.
Good
steal by Bellows.
And here's Bellows now in transition, up and under. She gets it to go.
Yeah, the unfortunate thing here, for the Bells tonight, as they draw a foul here, you know, the unfortunate thing for the Bells is that Hope's shooting percentage tonight is just kind of off the charts, especially from three. Their field goal percentage is, I don't have it right in front of me, but.
So as you can see from the replay there, it just looks like a little bit of contact there from Hope's Biggs, and here we're going to find Shadid at the free throw line. She can't get it to go. But yeah, like you said, Paul, I mean, you would imagine here Bell's got to head into conference play. Mm-hmm. They've done just okay, 3-4. They just have some work to do to try and figure some stuff out offensively. I just don't think they're scoring enough to be able to stay in ball games, especially at this level. And Hope College, top 10 team in the country at 14-2. And they're a team that, you know, when you come on the road, I don't know what you can expect for the coach of the Bells, but... Anyway, here come the Dutch. There's Ray. That's a nice dish. Bellows for three.
Nice shot.
Why not?
That left Olivia Bellows' hands with confidence, and it looked like when she knew that she let that go that ball was dropping in.
So quickly across the timeline, it's the Bells, and the foul is going to be on Jemison, just a little too much on the body on the floor.
Yep.
Jemison, three fouls in the game so far. Let's see what they decide to do. Almost stolen. She's lucky she doesn't get called for the foul there. Comes Bells at the top of the key. St. Mary's with the basketball, and here's Connolly. Connolly trying to dribble around it. Gets the ball down to Goralchek. That's a nice move by Goralchek. Too strong. Rebound by Raven Jemison. Here comes Bellows.
Ooh.
A little bit careless with the basketball.
Almost she's lost it there, yeah.
Trying to dribble drive. There's Kearns. Kearns out to Ray. Ray thought about it. She gets Lee down low. That's a wonderful job picking the ball away. But Ray out. Bellows for three. No, she's going to get called for the travel.
She wasn't quite sure about that one. She's disagreed with the referee there. Kind of gave him a little look like, I don't know what you were looking at, but, you know, again, I feel like I should have been keeping a chalkboard tally here, because I think that's about the 12th travel call tonight. Up and in for the Bells here now. Nice basket. Lena Ray bringing it up to court.
Here come the Dutch. Turns out to Ray. Around the horn, there's Bellows. She's got the ball. Trying to demand a nice drive. Can she get it out to the wing? There's Ray for three. Yep.
Yeah, nice kick out there.
Why not?
Bellows on that dribble drive and the smart kick out there for Lena Ray, who was just waiting in the corner for that three-pointer to fall.
Lena Ray, the freshman, playing some of her first minutes this year. Freshman from Utica. Can't get it to go at the buzzer. It turns 94-25. So the Hope College lead. That's after three quarters. We'll be back here with fourth quarter action from DeVos Fieldhouse.
Model, every student who comes through the doors of Hope College would have their tuition 100% covered.
Live from DeVos Fieldhouse. Matt Wainer alongside Paul Willard. Here in the fourth quarter, Hope College, 69-point lead.
Yeah.
Just 10 minutes play, going to have a lot of opportunities for freshmen. It's Kaiser, Sitzma, Carlblum, Vice, and Garner out there. Could be some girls that are going to get lots of minutes next year.
Oh, absolutely.
As they're already playing 10-plus minutes as freshman and sophomore here.
Yeah, you know, and Hope going with a little bit of a different approach this year than they had in the past year, where they had the starting five and then the almost like a hockey substitution of the next five, which we affectionately called the Chaos Crew last year. So, you know, Coach Mo mixing it up a little bit this year with his personnel and his substitutions, trying to see what works and what doesn't. And right now, everything is working for the Dutch tonight.
That's good to have a game like this, especially after the tough loss to Albion. As they look ahead, Calvin coming up next week. A couple of tough conference matchups on the schedule moving forward, and it's Garner here. Vice had enough room, doesn't make it go. There's Carl Bloom.
Oh, nice board there by Sietsma. Up and in, nice.
Sietsma gets it to go.
Kendall Sietsma, also a local product from local in West Michigan area from Hudsonville.
Let's pass out.
Nice Bells. Defense there. Ball kind of bouncing around. And now off of the Dutch here. Looks like it probably went off of Garner's hands there at the last second.
Bell's a little bit careless with the basketball. It's going to be Bell's basketball here. Get the ball in. That ball comes into Nia Porter. Down the left wing. She gets it up top, and that's to Matuza. Matuza down to Porter. Porter trying to get it. Yeah,
nice,
she gets
up and
nice
in there.
To go.
Yeah.
Once again, good experience minutes here for Hope College freshmen. Have opportunity. Carl Bloom for three. Nope, soft again. Sietsma with the board, but she's going to get called for the travel.
Number 13 on the travel tonight there.
So Hope College looking ahead. We've got Alma on Saturday. That's going to be here from DeVos. They're going back to Trine for that revenge game. Then they've got Albion.
As another revenge game.
Yeah, so Hope's got a couple of big ones come up. They needed this to be able to get that confidence, be able to move forward and know what they need and what's expected of them. Moving into some more conference games coming up.
Yeah, and you know, you mentioned the Albion game here. There's a special night for Hope fans and anybody who's in attendance. First 2,000 people were having a doubleheader that day against Albion, men and women, so we're doing an orange out. So even if you don't come and get a free t-shirt of this, the first 2,000, you know, come on out anyway, wear your orange, cheer on the Dutch and the Dutchmen as they face the Britons from Albion in a couple weeks here.
Or wear your orange if you're watching from the comfort of your own home.
That's true, too. Yeah.
Garner.
Oftentimes I'm watching the live stream in my Hope sweatshirt and just kind of hanging out on my couch.
As many of you are joining us here tonight watching from home, wish you a warm welcome from West Michigan. It's not too cold out here
if you're not
here in the great state of Michigan. But
not too cold outside, but the Dutch are turning up the heat in this building tonight.
That's a good one, Paul.
Yeah.
Vice.
I got to get one dad joke in.
Vice missing the front end of the one or the two shots, I'm sorry, and she gets the second to go. Hope approaching the century mark. Wow, you mentioned it. I mean, this new scoreboard really is beautiful. Love when you see new things happen here. That's a beautiful scoreboard. You got to come in here to DeVos and see it sometime.
Yeah. Yeah, come on out and check it out. It's we're kind of finally getting some of these things that have always been on the back burner updated. You know, it's just kind of one of those things where, you know, the right amount of funding and the right amount of resources came together to really give us this beautiful new scoreboard that we have here. Full LED panels allowing us to do video graphics now. You know, really feels like, as we were talking about during halftime, this facility feels like it rivals any sort of D1 facility out there.
Absolutely, and here's Hope College.
And another three.
Kaiser gets the three-pointer to go. Here come the Bells. Gets away with a travel. There's Matuza.
Oh, yeah.
And so they're going to get the foul. I believe that's going to be on.
Looked like she got away with a little bit of a travel and a hook.
Right.
A little hook play against Kaiser on the back there, but that's okay.
So Kaiser's on the foul, and her and Garner are going to take a seat on the bench. It's Ray, the freshman from Utica, coming back in, and then Bellows in the ball game as well. There's Matuza at the free throw line, gets it to go. 102-32 Hope College lead. They're past the century mark. Not the first time this year, that's for sure.
No, definitely not.
Tuzza gets a second to go. Here comes Kearns in the ballgame for Vice.
You know, this Dutch team, you know, the high-powered nature of their offense, you know, can't be denied, but certainly their defense is also something to behold, as St. Mary's is finding out tonight. Nice little slip screen down in there for Sietsma.
So Sietsma.
Great find by Ray down there, too.
Sietsma did a much better job getting positioning as she learned from some of her other colleagues how to be able to use her body to get the position that she needed down low. Nice shot by Townsend. I mean, you love to see. I mean, that's very, very practical for her to learn that if she can, look, she's getting down on the block early and often. If I can get my positioning, now she's too deep. When you get the ball at that position, you don't have many opportunities except for that kick.
Yeah, you're absolutely
right. So she's trying
to
get down there, beat her girl to the court. She can get on that block so she gets the positioning so she has a little more opportunity to score. When you get the ball that high, you got to dish out. Nice pass to Carlwood.
Oh, nice inbound play there. Yeah, and like you mentioned, too, I mean, Sietsma's got the height as well to get down in there and call for that high ball as it's coming in. And so, you know, a nice steal there by Sietsma as well.
Sietsma in transition. I guess she can dribble too. Up and under and one.
Wow. Have yourself a night, Kendall Sietsma. Well done.
Sietsma down now in double digits. She's got 10 points in the ball game. I love the way she squares her shoulders up, goes right through the contact. Nice strong take. Here Sietsma gets the free throw to go. 109-36, Hope College lead. Jemison coming in the ball game for Sietsma.
Sietsma going to the bench with 11 points now. You know, second in all scorers tonight after Savannah Feenstra with 13, and Kate Majerus and Sietsma are now tied with 11 apiece. And I'm sorry, Sydney Weiss also with 13 points tonight.
Foul gonna be on Bellows. Here it remains, St. Mary's basketball here. 5:53 left to go in the ball game. Townsend, top of the key, trying to initiate offense. Here's Townsend, triple driving, out to Porter. Porter at the free throw stripe, trying to put it on the ground to drive,
nice
but
steal.
Ray steals it. That's out to Carbloom. In the corner is Bellows. She does travel there. And I think it's just the way she gets set up. She likes to be a little bit on that front toe. So that's what she's doing, and that's what referee's explaining to her. You can't have, if you're going to pivot that foot, that counts as your pivot.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm glad that he's able to explain that to her, because I think she sets up in that same way every time. Here's Porter. Out, and Guma thinks about it. Guma drives. Ooh, that's a nice look.
Oh, a nice move.
She can't get it to go. And Guma gets her own board. She chucks, and she gets it. That's a nice chuck there.
That looked good from here, too. I mean, as soon as she let that go, I was like, that's dropping in.
Ray on the drive. Gets spacing. Out, and there's Kearns around the horn. Bellows, a little better.
Yeah, nice shot there by Olivia Bellows.
She said, where my feet set there, she gets that three to go.
That's right.
112-39, we're under five to play. It's been nothing but Hope College dominance here in both halves.
Oh, nice steal there by the Dutch.
Ill-advised entry pass by St. Mary's out in transition.
Oh, beautiful. Unselfish play by Hannah Kearns to leave that for Olivia Bellows for the up and in. Hannah Kearns, the lefty, you know, you don't see that too often. I think she's our only left-handed player. Nice steal by Courtney Lee.
Here's Ray. Finds Jemison too much.
Ooh.
Jemison gets the ball back in bounds, but it's taken away by Matuza.
Jemison with a nice hustle back down the court after taking out one of the cheerleaders down there almost.
So here's Porter looking to get some space to drive. She chucks, and she goes
off
the glass.
The bank is open for Porter. Nice shot there from Porter.
Here's Ray across the timeline initiating offense down to Jemison. This is the opportunity Oh, Hope College begin to try some different stuff, see if they can work on some things that they've been trying to see if they can get some confidence in other areas. Defense being the thing that Hope College has done so well this year.
Yeah.
Really being the staple for them as being a team that scores so much in transition.
Whoa.
Bounces home.
Shooter's bounce there for Porter on that three-pointer. Oh, nice find from Ray. Kearns with the lefty. Really, really great find there.
Timeout going to be by Coach Morehouse. We're going to take a quick break. Be right back here with Hope College basketball. Live here from Voss Field is 116-44. We're all but wrapped up here.
Yeah.
3 minutes and 20 seconds to play. Ball, it's been dominant from the Dutch.
It has indeed been dominant from the Dutch. You know, if you're a St. Mary's fan watching us tonight, first of all, thank you for tuning in. You know, we love to have your viewership here tonight. You know, a lot to like for what you're seeing from your team against an absolute buzzsaw of a Hope College Flying Dutch offense here, but you know, shot selection I think is one thing that I've noticed from St. Mary's that has been really strong tonight. You know, they've picked their shots and they've picked them well, and just they've had a couple of ones that just haven't fallen their way, but there again, a nice shot there. Pretty high percentage shot for her to take. And if you're St. Mary's, again, like I said, you got to like what you're seeing up against this high-powered offense.
So here's Hope College offense, dribble drive by Vase. So confident on the drive, but she can't get it off the glass. Rebound brought down by Shadid. Out in
nice
transition.
Nice steal.
Intercepted by Darrell Rivas, I mean Lena Ray, and it's out in transition. Here's Kaiser. Kaiser trying to get it out, and it's stolen by Shadid. Here comes Shadid. She's trying to go all the way with it, and she does.
Leaves it just a little short, unfortunately.
Here's Lena Ray. Initiating the Hope College offense out. Kaiser for three.
Oh.
Just off the front. Rebound is brought down by Connolly.
Little miscommunication there on the... Raven with the body before the block.
So they're going to get Jemison for the foul. That is her fifth, so she's fouled out of the ball game.
Yeah.
She did an excellent job tonight. Jemison finishing with 7 points. Bellows comes back in the ball game. Excellent job defensively by Jemison. It's tough for her to get that foul call on that block.
Yeah.
Anyways, here's Shadid at the free throw line. She gets the first to go. Gets the second free throw to go. Here's Ray setting up the Hope College offense. 2 minutes to play here in the ball game. Ray dribble drive. There's Vice on the kick. Vice getting down to Lee, getting her positioning. She's doubled out to Vise. Easy three. Just back.
Ooh.
Get it to go.
Little miscommunication there. Bell's on the break now, looking to push it. Oh, just an unfortunate. Put it too hard, too strong.
Out in transition.
Nice find there by Sydney Vice to Olivia Bellows for the left-handed finish. You know, again, Hope with that transition play just so quick off of the break, just able to get right in and score.
Here's Shadid.
Oh.
Ill-advised pass by Shadid, trying to get the ball to Townsend. It's too strong. Here comes Kearns back in the ball game for the Dutch. You got Kearns, Ray, Kaiser, Lee, and Bellows in the ball game.
Yeah, about a minute 15 left here. Hope with a dominant performance tonight. Courtney Lee with the shot, just a little off. Foul on Olivia Bellows as she was going for the ball. Yep. A little too much body on that one.
Bellows with two fouls now. We're in the one and one now. Sorry, maybe two shots here. It's going to be two shots for Mary Kate Giroux. Kate Giroux is the junior from Manassas, Virginia. Drives a ways to get to St. Mary's.
Yeah. Yeah, St. Mary's having quite a few players from all over the country. A player from Norman, Oklahoma. Like you mentioned, from Manassas, Virginia. A couple of South Bend, Indiana local products. For the Bells, as you know, St. Mary's is kind of pretty much right across the street from Notre Dame, down in South Bend there.
This is Lee around the horn. That's Kaiser. Beautiful kick.
Bellows for three, yeah.
Anytime
Olivia
she wants
Bellows,
to.
Have yourself an evening tonight.
Shot it well. Bellows now with 19 points. She shot great tonight. The rebound brought down here. Ray out to Bellows for 21 points. No.
Oh, no.
Can't get it to go. There's Hannah Kearns out, and there's Ray. Thinks about it. Lee.
Oh.
Lee can't get the two to go. Rebound brought down by the Bells. Here they are. Good athletic defense there by Kaiser.
Yeah. 15 seconds left here for the Bells. Looking to get one final point or 2 points for the evening here, probably.
Here in the last possession here, Townsend trying to get it down. Stolen by Kaiser, and she's going to hold the ball. Dribble out. That's going to be a Hope College victory. 121-51.
Yeah, what a great game for the Flying Dutch tonight. Here at DeVos Fieldhouse, you know, you got to love what you're seeing out of the Flying Dutch here. You really got to love, if you're a St. Mary's fan, to come in here up against a top 10 team, score 50 points, even though, you know, Hope was dominant for the entire series tonight. You really got to give your hats off to the Flying Dutch tonight.
So it's a great victory by Hope College to be able to come back from that loss to Albion.
Yep.
They look ahead. They got next week. They got Alma on Saturday. That's going to be here from Boss Fieldhouse. We will hear from you then. And that's all for us. It's Paul Willard and Matt Wehner.
Been a pleasure tonight, sir. Thank you.
Yep, and you will stay tuned here for the 8 p.m. start here for the Hope College men's game as they take on Adrian tonight at 8. It'll be Jordan George and myself will be on that call. So we'll see you here in about 35 minutes. Thanks again for tuning in.
There is a school whose namesake is... Not a founder, not a historical figure, not a state, city, or physical landmark. It is named after an ideal.